in the final of this stepladder match. Syafiq Ridhwan, of course, is 8 pins down against Clara Guerrero, who starts with that 8-pin advantage, being the female player. This is Wayne Boyce. Alongside me is Cass Edwards to take you through these two stepladder matches. And Guerrero, Cass, perhaps the most famous Colombian female bowler.
8 pins a game is what the lady bowlers get. And over 30 games, that actually adds up to quite a few pins to have over the men bowlers. So that's why you've seen two of them make the TV final.
And that's a pretty perfect way to start for Clara Guerrero. Takes all 10 in the first frame.
Yeah, nice looking shot. Slightly high on the head pin, just trips the four pin out there, but that came from Malaysia, who've made the trip over to Europe for this tournament. Looking to find out how the European conditions compare with back home in Asia. And he's done very well to get here into second spot. Not much of a pedigree. He has picked up a bronze medal in the Asian team games. And just making the national squad means he's got a bright future in the sport of 10-pin bowling.
Perfect starts. Concentration on the face of Syafiq Ridhwan. There's the second seed, remember, for the stepladder final. Finds the pocket again and works on a double.
Yeah, great looking shot from the young 25-year-old. Playing deep inside, round third and fourth arrow. Just getting the ball to come back. The oil on the lane conditioner down to...
Can Guerrero respond with a double of her own? Colombian-born, but based in the USA, in Florida. And the 28-year-old makes no mistake. It's a double as well for Guerrero. And this is a great start to this stepladder match one.
Two-time world champion in the Ladies World Championships 2009. As you said, Wayne, you're living in the United States now in Florida.
Oh, can she hit the three-in-a-row turkey, Clara Guerrero? Looking really focused. It's looking good, and it is three in a row for Clara Guerrero.
Yeah, very nice too, and there's a lot of thunder sticks out there.
They're getting plenty of opportunity to bang them together as well so far. Yes. Five strikes from five.
Banging the balloons. Everybody's perfect so far.
And makes it nonchalantly turned away. He knew it was there.
Well, yeah. He was very confident, wasn't he? Nice bit of roll. It's actually a fraction light. And he didn't see it, but it all counts. It's three strikes in a row, so we're all perfect through six frames.
Well, I was going to say, he didn't hang around to see them drop, did he? He was off for his next ball.
As much as some of the players have this week, especially as we saw Oscar Palermo playing right out on sixth arrow with his feet in the left-hand channel, bending that ball all over the place to shoot the 300 game.
Ridhwan then looking for a four-bagger and gets it perfectly into the pocket again. And remains perfect through four frames, the Malaysian.
Well, he's certainly come out all guns blazing, hasn't he? He's going to put pressure straight back on Clara, who's only got three in a row, so she needs another strike just to stay in touch. Very professional bowler. She's been in situations like this around the world before, in big major tournaments, been on television plenty of times. And I said she's a former world champion.
Well, who's going to flinch first? Seven from seven at the moment. Guerrero, remember, with that eight-pin advantage, the handicap. Oh, and it turned a bit too much, and it's left up the 10-pin.
Not a bad-looking shot. Not very much you would want to change with this. Quite a bit of rotation on it, more than the Malaysian man.
And make sure of it.
Straightens the shot out nicely. Plays from the left-hand side of the lane. A nice straight shot across to the right. Takes the 10-pin away.
Back on the trail again.
Yeah, she's pretty much lined up. No reason why she can't get right back in that pocket. It's just a matter of setting up that chain reaction in the 1-3 pocket for the right-hander. Just like that, and carrying all 10 pins. What a great shot.
That's exactly what she needed. after the spare in frame four. Just puts a little bit of pressure back on Syafiq Ridhwan, who's perfect so far. Oh, he's left an awkward looking split there, hasn't he?
High through the head pin, leaves the 4-6 and the 7 pin. Just didn't seem to get down to this one. Didn't get through the shot because it's come up early. Flush through the face of the head pin. Wayne, you don't see too many of these converted. As you say, this could be likely. And it is the first open frame at the halfway stage. To that four in a row that he started with.
Needs at least a double now, doesn't he, really, to try and cover that, if he can. And that's not a bad way to start.
Yep, great looking shot. Man for Malaysia, gets the crowd going, and gets back on strikes. Just a reminder that Clara is 8 pins ahead before they even threw the first ball. It's a handicap that the lady bowlers get on the European Tour. Like it or not, it encourages the ladies to play in the men's division. There's no separate divisions. And that's just one of the things that the men have to put up with. So if a lady shot a 300 game, she would actually score 308.
Yeah.
Which sounds quite silly, really, but that's the way the rules are.
She's left two there.
Yeah, high through the face, leaves the three and the six pin standing. Just losing her footing a little bit there. That could have been the reason the ball didn't make the pocket. Looking to hook the ball too much.
Four strikes so far, a spare in frame four. Makes the spare.
People tend to forget about until the last frame, and all of a sudden, oh, I've lost by 5 pins. Looking to get back on strikes, and she does. Great looking shot.
Yes, great stuff against Carolyn Dorin-Ballard.
Well, I suppose officially on paper, if that happens, they will both have 8 pins, but it will, to all intents and purposes, be a scratch game between the two ladies.
And that's a strike again for Syafiq. Yeah. Gets the double.
And hits the wall shot. Carries the 5 and the 7 pin, which were both late. Light in the pocket. There's the 5 and the 7.
We're really nip and tuck this first step ladder match. Oh, leaves the 10.
Dear, oh dear, 10 pin after a double. It's unfortunate when those corner pins don't go. You think you're lined up with 2-3 strikes in a row, and all of a sudden one just stands there defiantly. Didn't even wobble, did it? So he's going to have to make the spare just to stay in this one. She'll be right back in the match.
Yeah, absolutely crucial she takes all 10 here.
A power, a lot of rotation.
Oh, lovely.
And a great bit of hook in the back end there. Really just absolutely rips the 1-3 pocket, carries all 10 pins, and that is the double she's looking for.
I can see why some players don't like the 8-pin advantage. I mean, the way she's bowling here, I mean, she doesn't need it.
Well, the, as you say, you know, if one of the lady bowlers comes out and averages 220, she's then averaging 228, which shuts out quite a few of the men players and gets the ladies high up into the tournament. And as we've seen in this tournament, 3 of the top 4 were actually female bowlers. Oh. So it does have an effect.
So that's a 7 pin up.
So it's a 4 pin standing, which should be a straightforward spare. Now, Syafiq has got some work to do here. It's foundation frame for him, frame number 9.
More than 20 pins in the last two frames.
A strike would do nicely, and he's got one, but he really needs to double up on this now on lane 15. Just chips the 10 pin away there. Gives him the chance to make the double, which he really must do now. It's the last frame. Big ball, this one. Really needs to be 10. Make the double. Well, only just hit the head pin, didn't he? Leaves the 2-pin standing. Not the best shot of the game, and he'll realise that. He may also realise that he's given Clara the chance to overtake him and win this one. This can only be a spare. Well, make the spare, and he's got the bonus ball in the 10th frame. He can only make 224.
He would have loved to have had two bonus balls. And he does at least finish with a strike.
Score of 224, not bad, not quite good enough, I think. I just thought I'd mention that. Surely it can't happen.
Well, but there's the nine. Well, there's the nine anyway. Now, you'd expect the way she's playing for her to take the spare. Of course, we have seen them missed, especially when there's plenty of pressure on it, as there is with this next shot.
A nine miss will give her 216, plus eight will be 224.
I'll tell you what, it had a wobble, you know.
It's still standing there.
I know.
A spare will be good.
Spare will give her the bonus ball.
Hard and straight, and that's your winner, Clara Guerrero from Colombia.
Well, he's happy enough, isn't he?
He's very happy to come third. He's just lost 2,500 euros, but he doesn't seem to care.
No, well, he's gonna get a cheque for 5,000 euros. And it is going to be an all-female final. I think I'm right in saying, Cass, that there's only ever been one previous female winner of this event, isn't there?
Yes, it was the inaugural event back in 2004. It was Denmark's Britt Bronsted won the tournament.
But it's an all-female final this time around. Well, he was pretty happy, Syafiq Ridhwan. Let's hear from him.
I'm feeling happy because I finished in third position. The one split cost me, so I lose because of one split. Because I make a mistake, I throw a little bit inside. So bowling is, cannot say anything.